Why do you exist, and what's the purpose of your life? Hi, I'm Pastor Brian Holmes with MPowered Christian Ministries, here with a lesson from our Driveway Discipleship program. Let's dive in. Why do you, anyone, or anything exist? Are we a cosmic accident, the result of single-celled organisms evolving into humans, like evolutionists believe? Others believe that everything, including each of us, is a part of God, and our unique individualities aren't even real. They're merely an illusion, and the belief that we're all separate individuals is the cause of the suffering, war, and conflict in the world. But these are not true. This lesson explains, 1, you are a uniquely designed individual. 2, God created you for His glory. And 3, the purpose of your life is to glorify God through Jesus. 1, you're a uniquely designed individual. You have your own unique story with personal experiences, memories, and lessons. Do you have unique feelings, desires, and preferences that are different from others? Do you have your own unique dreams, plans, and goals for the future? I know I do, so I know you do too. Everything seems to look and feel like we're all people because we are. We're created by a personal God for His own distinct and special purpose. And God is loving, always does what is good, just, true, and right, and He desires a relationship with you. This isn't a fairy tale. It's actually true. God knew you from eternity future before you were even born. He created you with individual characteristics, talents, and passions. He's known you your entire life, and He's always been near. God said to Jeremiah in Jeremiah 1:5, "Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I set you apart." Let our praise to God mimic David's in Psalm 139, verses 13 through 16. "For you created me and my inmost being. You knit me together in my mother's womb. I praise you because I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Your works are wonderful. My frame was not hidden from you when I was made in the secret place, when I was woven together in the depths of the earth. Your eyes saw my unformed body." 2, God created you to bring Him glory. There's one true God, and He's the creator of everything else that exists. He alone brings life and causes death, controls blessings and curses. He deserves all the glory, honor, and worship. He's a personal being, and He's offended when we give the glory due to Him to other things. It's a very serious sin called idolatry. When we worship other things, we get further away from knowing who He is, what He's like, and from having a personal relationship with Him. Plus, we get further away from discovering the reasons He made us the way He did, and His unique plan and purpose for our life. But these are the reasons He created us. God made you so that who you are and what you do with your life would please Him. Jesus came to share God's, who He called His Father's, heart with us. Jesus came to teach us who God really is, and what's really important to Him. He taught us why we were created, and the real reason that there's death, pain, suffering, illness, evil, poverty, war, abuse, demons, and all the other problems in the world. Jesus taught that these bad things are the result of us, created beings, worshiping ourselves and other false gods, instead of the true God. Jesus taught that it's our own selfish, sinful desires and actions that cause the brokenness in the world. We're all guilty to one degree or another. Every one of us is selfish and sinful, and we've all done things we shouldn't have that have brought dishonor to God. He made a creation that was supposed to be good, but we've gone bad. God created us so that we could know Him and live with Him forever, but we've all sinned and rebelled against Him. He created us to bring Him glory, to be a creation that pleases Him, but none of us truly do. Even when we try hard, we'll still fall short. Jesus said in Matthew 19, verse 17, that there is none good but God alone. We can't be perfect no matter how good we are, how much we help those in need, nor how many laws or rules we follow. We can never be perfect like God, even though God desires us to be perfect like Him. Jesus said so in Matthew 5, verse 48. The problem can't be fixed by following rules. God doesn't only look at our outward actions. He also looks at our hearts. He sees the selfish motivations, the wicked, sinful desires on the inside. But He did make a way for all of us to be able to bring Him glory. 3. The purpose of your life is to glorify God through Jesus. God could have made us like robots, without the ability to sin or to choose to do anything that wasn't pleasing to Him if He wanted to. God does want you to obey Him, but submission and obedience is not the main thing He desires. God wanted us to be able to know Him and His heart, and to actually genuinely love Him for who He is. Not merely what He is, God, but who He is. I mean, loving Him because we can see that He's lovely, and we have actual affection for Him because there is an actual, real, personal relationship with Him. Through Jesus, we can know God. We don't glorify God the most by just following rules or by being the best person we can be. We glorify God the most by believing in Jesus and trusting in the gospel. We glorify God most by seeing our need for a Savior and by believing in the Savior that He sent. Jesus said in John 6, verses 39 and 40, "And this is the will of Him who sent me, that I shall lose none of all those He has given me, but raise them up at the last day. For my Father's will is that everyone who looks to the Son and believes in Him shall have eternal life, and I will raise them up at the last day." By believing in this good news and following Jesus, we understand who God is and begin to have a real relationship with Him. God loves you, and He has an amazing plan for your life. By choosing to repent of our sins, believing in Jesus, and letting Him be our Lord and Savior, we glorify God with our lives. God said to Jeremiah in Jeremiah 29, verse 11, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future." This is true for us as well. The Apostle Paul recognized this for himself in Galatians 1, verses 15 through 16, where he says, "God, who set me apart from my mother's womb and called me by His grace, was pleased to reveal His Son in me." Just as Jeremiah and Paul have unique stories, you have one as well. And your story is merely one small piece in God's larger master narrative. When we allow the gospel to impact our lives and become the highlight of our story, we begin to realize how important it is to share this good news with others. And as we share this news with others, God, you, me, and all of us get to play a role in the gospel, touching their lives too. And then their story is part of our story, which is interwoven with God's story. And then we all glorify God together forever. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, you created me to know you and glorify you forever through your Son, the gospel, and my unique story. Help me to fulfill my highest purpose in life. In Jesus' name, amen.